fitness industry is an opportunity to do work that matters. Fight Factory aims to make a living, but not before helping people change their lives in the process. So, if you're ready to make that change with them, be prepared to put your gloves up. If it's a full body workout you want, you're probably going to be interested in contact sports like what Fight Factory offers. From mixed martial arts, Brazilian jiu-jitsu, boxing, and Muay Thai, anyone who's really looking to fight and look like a fighter without going in the ring are promised to get an intense and hardcore workout. But with many other gyms already jumping on the trend brought about by the popularity of the mixed martial arts scene, we'll have to find out what makes them different.
With this one, we get good quality boxer from Elorde and, you know, really good quality jiu-jitsu and MMA instructors from DEFTA. I think it's the quality of the instructors. You know, like here in Fight Factory, we have some of the best boxers, some of the boxers, former national teams, URCC champions teaching. And then we have two black belts in jiu-jitsu, which is not a lot of gyms can boast of a team like that.
When it comes to the actual exercise and the fitness benefits and the amount of calories you can burn, how does mixed martial arts compare with other sports?
In terms of shaping your body, I think martial arts is very unique because you do strength and conditioning at the same time. Other sports you'll do mostly just conditioning or mostly just strength training or muscle toning. No? With martial arts, you do both at the same time. So it's like hitting two birds with one stone. You don't have to spend another, you know, training session just to build muscle or just to do your cardio. You're doing cardio and strength training at the same
time. Right, it's all in one.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then, of course, it's more efficient. It's more efficient.
So if I want to see significant changes in my body and my fitness level, how often should I be coming to FFM?
Personally, me, I would train like 4 or 5 times a week. That's average. That's average for most people. Most of our clients train 4 or 5 times a week. But you can see results in as little as 2 to 3 times a week.
Tell me about the different packages and the pricing that we can find here.
Okay, we have special packages. Like, we have an annual membership. Depending on branches, 1,000 to 2,000 pesos. And the annual membership gets you discounts on your session rates. For example, a boxing session in Fort would cost 450 pesos. But if you're an annual member, which means you pay 2,000 for the whole year, you get it for 350. So you have a savings of 100 pesos every session. All right, that's for the annual membership. And then we have monthly packages. Like we have 15 sessions for boxing, which would be around like 3,000 to 3,500 pesos per month. And then we have unlimited packages, 4,000 a month. For jiu-jitsu, it's 3,500 per month. That's unlimited jiu-jitsu sessions. All right, and then we have per session rates, which is around 400 more or less.
So, Alan, you own the Fight Factory, which is an MMA and jiu-jitsu gym.
Yes.
And you have Muay Thai as well.
Correct.
Obviously, you were into these sports before you started the business. How did you get into the sports?
I did MMA in high school because I was watching UFC and I decided to enroll in some classes. And then there I started doing some submission fighting, and then I did boxing, you know, kickboxing. I got into Team DEFTA, which is where I met most of the partners here in Fight Factory. And that's where I started doing MMA.
What attracted you to these particular sports?
Maybe like all the old movies, the old Kung Fu movies, like Bruce Lee, Jackie Chan. I started liking martial arts because of Bruce Lee, actually. And then, you know, watching UFC, of course.
And so now you've been running this business for about 2 years. What made you decide to turn this hobby into a business as well?
Before, we were training in a gym near this FFM branch. Huh? And then the gym was about to close down. So me and a couple of friends, we decided to, and we talked, and then we said we need a place to train in. We did it for the passion of martial arts, not really for, you know, for profit or business. We just needed a place to train. And then, you know, the Fight Factory idea came up. And then, you know, we decided to start first with jiu-jitsu and MMA. And then we decided that we needed boxing just to sustain the business. So we partnered up with Elorde. That's where Elorde Fight Factory started.
Who are the types of people you find are coming to Fight Factory?
We have different clients. Like, we have clients who are 4 years old. And we have clients as old as, you know, as young as 75, 80. And in terms of male and female, it's 50-50, male, female. So I can't really say there's like a target market. If you look around, we don't really do a lot of marketing in Fight Factory. We don't have banners. We're not super active in the internet. The location and the place is like our marketing tool. And you know, the people just come in from all walks of life and different ages, different, you know, backgrounds.
So would you say people in this area, in this community in Quezon City, know where to go? Like, they know about Fight Factory?
When we opened up this Morotow branch, for the first few months, it was, the inflow of people was a bit slow. But after, like, there was a month that, I think after 2 or 3 months, I think word got around. It's like mostly word of mouth. Like I said, we don't do any marketing.
Right. And is that on purpose?
It's on purpose.
Why is that?
Well, number one is to save the cost of marketing. You know? And number two, I don't think we really have to do the marketing. The feel of the place is like a family business. Although we're friends, right? But it's like a family business. We go by word of mouth.
And it seems that you have a lot of repeat customers, right?
Yes.
You have a strong community of people who keep coming back here. How are you able to do that? Because that's very important in any business.
I think the quality of the trainer is very important. You know, that's the number one thing. If the customer doesn't like the trainer, the person won't come back. If she didn't like the training, the first experience, she won't come back, or the person won't come back. So I think the quality is the like number one thing. And if there's a dip in quality with the trainers, we address it right away. Like if customer tells us na I need to do more rounds and this trainer didn't offer to do extra rounds in boxing, we tell the trainer the next time you have to offer a few more rounds of mitts exercises.
How important is it for you guys to sort of make an impact in the lives of your clients? How much do you want their lives to be affected by what they do here in the gym?
Coming from a martial arts background, I'm an instructor myself, so it's for me, it's very personal. I take it really personal that the goals of the clients be met. We're not just here to do mitts and then send the client off. We make sure that they meet their goals, and when they leave, they know how to also defend themselves. Of course, we pride ourselves in the efficiency on how the clients meet their goals, how fast they can lose this amount of weight, or how fast they build this amount of muscle.
Of course, you also have the clients who come here not just because they want to be fit or lose weight, but you have the ones who really want to be fighters and actively compete. What can you do for them?
Well, like I said before, we have the best team, best boxers, we have the best jiu-jitsu fighters, we have the best MMA fighters actually in the country. Just from the experience alone, we can mold people who want to become professional in MMA or in boxing or in Muay Thai. We can mold them into what they want. You know, we can make them professionals.
So, you know, we could say that you really cover the whole spectrum of people who are interested in martial arts, right? Because they're the people who are just doing it for fun and fitness, and then the ones who...
Hardcore martial arts.
Do you think any of these sports are a fad?
I don't think it's a fad. Fads, it would fade. And, you know, even before Fight Factory, boxing's been around in the Philippines for like a really long time. You know, and it's just, it's growing. The boxing community is getting bigger. All right, martial arts is getting bigger. If you look at, you know, in the States, the MMA gyms are, since UFC started, the MMA gyms have been growing. You know, it's not something that, it, you know, parang uso, it's not uso. You know, it's growing steadily.
How much time do you spend here every day or every week?
I would say around, I go here like 2 hours a day, every day, almost every day. I would teach for like, in a week, I do like maybe 6 hours. 6 hours, that's around 3 classes. And then my other partners would handle the other classes also. But for boxing, we have the trainers, all right? So for the partners, we just teach jiu-jitsu.
In terms of your growth, what are the opportunities out there for Fight Factory?
For now, it's just looking for another location and maybe opening up another branch. Maybe one of the opportunities we're looking at.
So talk to me about the profitability of Fight Factory, because as you said, you do have a strong student body that comes here, but you also don't actively market or advertise.
Yeah. We earn from the customers. We make sure that the quality is on par, and all the FFM gyms are They're in sync. We didn't start this because of profit. We started because of the passion. All the partners here are martial artists. Most of them are competitors. And we just wanted really to share our knowledge and what we have to the public. Profit is just an added bonus to that. It's more of like a passion for us.